Hello dear traders, this is Petko Aleksandrov and I have decided to record a video about the recent update we have in EA Studio for the walk forward and especially for the walk forward optimization. And I have just recorded a lecture for the upcoming course where I'm talking more about the walk forward optimization, so I decided to record such a lecture for the series of videos where I show the updates in EA Studio Strategy Builder. Okay, so here I have two strategies that I generated and I will click on one of those. It is for pound yen on M15 and I will show you first what is the update in the optimizer. So if I just run one optimizer without changing anything, you will see that the balance chart will show two equity lines. One is with the old strategy or with the initial strategy. This is the gray color line. And the new one, normally higher, shows the strategy results after the optimization. And you can see here the numbers of strategies, but they're not going into the collection. Just they show here as a change. And finally, after the optimizer is ready, we will see the new inputs and we will see the difference between the new strategy, the optimized strategy, and the initial strategy. And this is very nice because we can see the difference and we can decide if we want to use it or we don't want to use it. Now, because I have selected to use step of one, probably this will go to over optimized strategy, and as you can see the balance line is really really nice, but I will wait just a little bit more to see the new result and I will continue the video once it is ready. All right, the optimization is ready and you can see the new parameters and the new equity line, much better than the initial one. And you can see here I have the green button edit, which means that if I select it, I will use the new strategy and I will go to the editor with the parameters of the new strategy. If I don't want to use it, I just go back to the editor and here is the initial strategy. Okay, so this is the update in the optimizer. And now let's go to the walk forward. As you know, what the walk forward does, it divides the whole backtested period on different segments. By default, it divides the period on 5 segments. And if I click on start, it starts to optimize the strategy for the 70% of the first period. And this is if I have selected to use 30% out of sample. And then it will simulate trading for the rest 30% of the first segment. And when it is ready, it will start the new optimization. So it will be from the beginning of the second purple line until the end of it. And then it will perform trading or it will simulate trading for the next zone. Okay. And this is how walk forward works. I have explained it in more details in the course Top 10 Dollar Cat Expert Advisors. And this process repeats till the end. It optimizes for the period, then it simulates trading for the next zone or for the next segment. And you can see the first one is already shown. So here we have the result with the new parameters. Now, what is the update with the walk forward? If I go to parameters, you can see that now the parameters of the different segments are available. Something that was not visual and we didn't see before, what are the parameters. Now we see here the original parameters of the strategy. And then after the first optimization, we see the parameters of the segment. And actually here we see very clearly the change. If it is a smaller number, we see in red. And if it is a bigger number, we see it in green. Actually, if it is equal, again, it is in green, but below for the envelopes period, you can see that it changed from 38 to 52. That's why it is in green. But after the next optimization, it went down to 35 and then it didn't change. So here we have very, very visually how the parameters are changing for each segment. And then on the right side, we have the out of sample net profit, where we see the original strategy, how it performed in the different segments. And after the optimization, what is the result? So here we can see that in the first segment, it made a little bit of a worse result. With the second one, it's better. It was 8 and now it is 42. And below we have full backtest with the last parameter. So here in gray color, again, we see the initial strategy. And at the end, when the walk forward is ready, it will perform a backtest with the last parameters. And this is the key point here. After all optimizations are ready, using the out of sample, with the last parameters, okay, the last parameters are at this point here. After the optimization of this period, it will simulate trading, it will show us the result till the current moment, but it will perform a complete backtest taking these last parameters. So right here, I will see the new equity line compared to the original backtest. And what is the idea here? Very simply, if the new strategy with the recent parameters shows better results, simply we have a better strategy because it had out of sample for the recent period, okay, for this period right here. And in the same time, we can filter it with the out of sample of the acceptance criteria. And in this case, I have selected to use 1.1 profit factor for the complete backtest. All right. And 1.1 profit factor for the in sample part and for the out of sample part. So simply we can filter the strategies when we use the walk forward optimization in the reactor. But let me wait for the complete backtest to be ready and I will show you about the reactor and how we can use now the walk forward optimization and the reactor. So now I can see the last parameters and basically now we have the last simulated trading for the last segment. Okay, so far the strategy looks better. And let me see till the end if we will have a better backtest or not. I will click on parameters again. And you can see that we have the indicators for the Williams percent range changed. We have the accelerator oscillator changed and we have the envelopes changed. So all of the parameters were changed during the walk forward. Only the stop loss and the take profit were not changed, but because I did not select from the settings to optimize stop loss and take profit. All right, it is ready now. So let's go to parameters and see the result. What we see here is that the strategy made worse profit. Okay, it is much below the equity line of the original strategy. And at the end, it made less profit. And here in the full back test validation, we have, is strategy better? No, okay, because it made less profit. And from validation, you can set what to be the criteria. And I have selected here to use $10 as a minimum. So I just want to see strategies with very small profit. Or let's say I want to see the positive strategies and not the negative strategies. So just to summarize it one more time, after the walk forward is ready, it takes the last parameters from the last segment and it performs a complete backtest. and it compares this complete backtest with the original strategy. As well, we can see that the common acceptance criteria was not validated for the backtests, for the backtest with the last parameters. Anyway, we can see that the outcome of each segment is positive, but it's not validated as well, because in validation, one more time, we need to see minimum $10 of a profit, and in two of the segments we have $2, and in the last one we have $3, which is still below the $10 I have selected. Alright, and now to compare it with the equity chart of the different segments, we can see that the walk forward succeeded to make a better equity line. But this is the result of the walk forward when it's optimizing one segment, testing the strategy for the next one, then adding the data and testing it till the end. And we have a better strategy here. So this gives us a sign that the strategy is not over optimized. But in parameters, we see that with the last inputs of the indicators, the strategy actually made worse result than the original strategy. So in order to say that the strategy was validated, we want to see a better strategy than the original one, the common acceptance criteria to be validated, and in this case it's not validated, and in the same time we want to see all segments validated. Now here they are green, which means they are positive, but according to the validation they are not validated, because I requested minimum $10 of a profit. Okay, this is criteria for validation of the segments out of sample part. Alright, and I will go now to the other strategy just to show you what is the difference. So I will click on the second strategy that I have, and again I will go to the walk forward, and using the very same inputs, the settings, 30% out of sample, the validation, $10, I will click on start and I will wait for it to complete, and I will continue the video then. Alright, the test is ready, and what you see is that the walk forward failed to show a better strategy when it went through the different segments, but you can see that in the full backtest validation we have a better strategy. Is strategy better? Yes, this is because if I go to parameters, in the full backtest with the last parameters, we have a strategy with more profit. Okay, so it's taking the last parameters from the last segment and it performs a backtest for the complete period, for the whole historical data, and it shows the result over here. And what we see is that this strategy first went down, then it went a little bit on a positive, but recently, and especially in the out of sample period, it showed much better result, just going up, and finally it has better net profit than the original strategy. So simply this way we have the same strategy but with better parameters, and it is up to you if you want to use this strategy. But in this case, it does not allow me to use this strategy because the edit button is not in green. And in order to have this strategy validated, or to say that the walk forward validation or the walk forward optimization was successful, we need to see three things. One is all segments to be validated. And here I have only one of the segments not validated because it has net profit below 10. And as I said, I have selected here to use 10. The second thing is to have the whole backtest with the last parameters to be validated with the acceptance criteria, which is not valid What I see from the statistic is that we have the profit factor 1.71 with the original strategy, and then we have after optimization 109, okay, which is less than 1.1, which is what I have selected in the acceptance criteria. As well, the second segment is not validated, it has only $9 and I want to have minimum $10. And the third thing is the strategy to be better than the original one, which is true here, but the other two are not. So one more time, to have a successful walk forward, we need three things. One, the strategy to be better. The second one, the segments to be validated according to what you choose in validation. And the third one, to fulfill the acceptance criteria for the complete backtest at the end. And here it failed as well. And the walk forward is included now in the reactor, so you can use it, but I have tested it already and I can tell you that it is really, really hard to get strategies, but this is the idea. It filters the strategies very, very well because it uses many things. So for example, in the generator settings, if you use out of sample, it will run the generator with out of sample. It will pass the strategies down according to the acceptance criteria. They will go to the walk forward optimization. And there you can choose what out of sample to use. You can use the same one. You can use if you want to fulfill the acceptance criteria, and you can use the segments. And I can tell you that I have run reactors for a couple of hours and I get just 2-3 strategies at the end of the day. And this is great because it really filters the strategies a lot. And this way they go one time through the out of sample with the generator. Then they are filtered with the common acceptance criteria. Then they will go to the walk forward where it does out of sample for the different segments. It performs backtest without a sample for the parameters of the last segments. And if the three things are satisfied, which I have said, then it will go to the Monte Carlo. And here, what is the difference between the walk forward optimization and the walk forward validation? Is that the walk forward validation just validates the strategies. So if you want to validate the strategy that is coming from the generator, you can validate it with the walk forward or with the Monte Carlo, but they don't change the strategy, okay? They don't change the parameters of the strategy. And if you want to use the walk forward optimization, then it will change the strategy with the last parameters from the last segment, okay? And if the strategy is validated, it will proceed further. So it is up to you how you want to use it. And here we have full data optimization, which is the normal optimizer that we had so far. It is just named full data to make clear that this is optimizer using the complete historical data, okay? And with the walk forward, we use different segments. And the best thing is to use one of the three. No need to use the full data optimization, the walk forward optimization, and the walk forward validation. I prefer, from the tests that I did so far, to use the walk forward optimization. Of course, I will test it more, and if I have something new to share with you, I will do that. I will appreciate if you share your opinion in the forum. Don't hesitate to drop some pictures, ask questions, but so far what I saw, it just gives a better strategies at the end of the day when it uses the last parameters, it validates, it uses the out of sample at the same time for the segments and for the complete backtest. And when we use it in the reactor, we really, really filter a lot the strategies till they come into the collection. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. I would really appreciate as well if you subscribe to the YouTube channel, if you liked the video, so you will follow all new updates I do for EA Studio or for my trading. Thanks for watching, and I always wish you safe trading. Cheers.